So, this is how Hong Kong U has changed my life. Before coming to Hong Kong U, English is fun and optional despite classes and exams. Now English is compulsory, inescapable, synonymous to pain and torture, and sometimes necessary for survival. Before Hong Kong U, presentation is among the advanced vocabulary. Tutorial is something unheard of. Professor is a respectful professional. Now, presentation is present. Tutorial is tutor. Professor is professor. Before Hong Kong U, I went to bed at 11 p.m. the latest, occasionally at 2 a.m. when I would hide in bed to read novels or watch films. Now I still sleep at 11 p.m. probably because I did not sleep the day before. 2 a.m. is the usual hour for bed, but during revision and exam period, I sleep? Before Hong Kong U, I wore jumper during winter and shorts during summer. Now I wear jumper during summer and shorts during winter, and most of the time I wear suits for high table dinner, presentations, and job interviews.
Could you offer brief speculation on how the recent Malaysia Airlines incident would influence the marginal revenue of the human resource department, please?
Before Hong Kong U, library is for reading and classroom is for listening to teachers. Now learning center is for naps, classroom is for naps, library is for naps. Before Hong Kong U, home meant comfort, shelter and relaxation. Parents meant support, wise advice, love and care. Now I talk to my parents regularly every week, updating them about how I am doing with study, what happens in my life, who I meet, when I sleep, and what I need. And home means food. Before Hong Kong U, I followed the textbooks, I followed my parents' expectations, I followed what everyone agreed on. Now I feel I start to live as an independent individual with ambition and aspiration. I must have good GPA, I must have many internships, I must have many part-time jobs, and I must not back out of illegal employment, as long as it makes the quickest money. Before Hong Kong U, my happiness was simple. It would make me super happy working out a math problem, and it would make me even happier getting good grades in the ranking examinations. Now I take a selfie of me cooking for myself, post it on Renren, post it again on Facebook, post it once more on Weibo. In the meantime, I see photos of Kevin traveling to Tokyo, Catherine attending an international business meeting, Rachel with a foreign friend, Jackie with a bunch of foreign friends, David posting a status, you guys rock, hashtag New Year's Eve at Lan Guifang, hashtag, and 65 people leaving a like. I think I'm happy. So, this is how Hong Kong U has changed my life.
母该膝该打一会儿摇落。